Hello everyone. Thank you first of all for giving me an opportunity to speak, record this video and send it to you. And my paper pertains to reverse zoonosis in COVID-19 are animals at risk of infection. Hello everyone. Myself, Dr. Samarbir Singh Rathore from Department of Zoology, St. John's College, Agra. And I'm presenting here my findings, which are basically related to this COVID-19. And all of us know that this problem started from a wet market in Wuhan, where a person came in contact with a bat and other animals, which because we have a limited study, and therefore they were infected, and thereafter it starts spreading from animal to human to human. Now, this particular paper pertains to how does the COVID positive people have infected other animals. So we are here to judge up a case that how relevant is that and what are those cases. Now, first thing is zoonotic or zoonosis has been a name which is heard by many people. And this is because the animals have a lot of germs, and those germs can be transmitted to human when you come in contact with them. But the reverse zoonosis is something reverse of that. Person who is having a particular disease or carrying those germs then transmit it to other animals which are not infected with these. So this is called as a reverse zoonosis. And if you talk about like coronavirus and COVID-19 is said to be a novel human pathogen. But in last 3 decades, there have been 30 human novel pathogens, and WHO says somewhere around 60 to 72% of the cases of related to epidemic will be of zoonotic nature. It means that they would be spread by animals also. How does it happen? It happens basically by 4 ways. You come in contact with a person, like a COVID positive person comes in contact with the animal and then it is infected. Indirect contact means a person touching up a surface, contaminating up a surface, and thereafter it is then animal comes in contact with that contaminated surface. So there is an indirect contact. Vector-borne means many animals are there. For example, mosquito spreads malaria. In the same way, there are other vectors which can spread this particular disease. Waterborne is again a thing that humans have come in contact with the water, and that infected water is used by an animal, and so the reverse zoonosis can actually happen. And how many, what are the particular spread of microbiology in case if you see? In case if you see this particular publication of Messenger and Barnes 2014, they have cited 56 publications. And they have said that the total spread of all these things from bacteria, virus, parasitic, and fungal. Now, let me discuss those cases of animal infection. Case one, there was a tiger in Bronx known as Nadia. They, along with the other three, were infected with this particular coronavirus. And a person who was taking care of this in a zoo was asymptomatic. And thereafter, this virus came into a these bigger cats. The case second is about a dog in Hong Kong. You might have seen this is one of the case that a Pomeranian is there of a 17-year-old. Other than this, there were two German Shepherd also who were tested positive. All animals which were having COVID positive owners. Third case is again of a New York in which two pet cats were noted, and a person was COVID positive and they were the owners of these pets, and hence this was there. So basically, there are not many reasons behind this, but why such zoonosis happens and reverse zoonosis happens, as it is clearly described. I will go very fast. Let me come to the main findings. After going through many publications, this is one study which is by Harbin Veterinary Research Institute researchers. And in that, what they have done is that they have deliberately exposed group of cats, dog, parrot, pigs, and chickens. And thereafter, they have tried to see the action that how far the infection spreads and what are those things from rectal swab, from oral swabs and other things. And the biggest conclusion they came was that cats are more susceptible. So bigger cats like tigers and cats and parrots are more susceptible as compared to other people, those other animals which can come into infection. Now, the first thing, the major discussion of this paper is most susceptible to end COVID-19 infection. But at the same time, there have been papers which interestingly show that there is no such scientific evidence and no research studies, in fact, that can prove that pets can spread these diseases. So we actually don't need to worry about that. What is to be worried is that India is approximately a hub of many animals, because you see 66% of the people live in rural areas and they are having a large domestic animal population. And there are other factors also which may aggravate this cause. So this is what I've highlighted in this paper, and these are the references. And a big thank you. Stay safe and help stop coronavirus. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.